Hello crazy coders, welcome to yet another video on our GUI projects with Tkinter. Today we will make a quiz game which will look something like this. It will have question, it will have options, and it options will having be a checkbox which we can tick and untick, and also it will have a next button. If you click on the next button, it will move to the next question with a new question and new options. And also when you click again, it will move to the next question until the last question appears, and when you are done with the last question, the score will be displayed. So let's start creating.
I've already created a new Python file and named it quizgame.py. The first thing, we'll import everything from Tkinter, which we can do by this, from Tkinter import all, and after that we'll just create a window with which will be a instantiation of TK class, and after this we'll just update the title, which will be quiz game, and now we'll just enter into main loop to check our window is available or not. Yes, it's available. Now let's do the population of the widgets. So first thing, I will create a root frame, which I will tell you why later, but let's do that. Simply, root is a frame and we'll just pack it. And in the root, first thing I want to add is a question label, so I will just name it question, and which will be a label. First thing, it will take a root. I will keep the width 60, and I think let's keep the font 10, and for time being text be question. So question, and now just pack it. Cool, so our question label should be ready. Yes, it's ready. Now moving towards our check buttons. So before that, I will create three variables named val1, val2, val3. These will be special variables of Tkinter, which will be int var. So I will tell you why we are using it. So first of all, let me copy paste it. Yes. So int var is a special variable class. So val1 is a special variable of int, but what it does is, if we pass this to a widget, then we can actually get what user is interacting with a widget. So now let's create our check buttons. So first of all, I will create option 1 with a check button, which will be in root, and I will pass a variable as val1, and after that I will just keep for time being text as option 1. Okay, now I just to just pack it. option1.pack. This sounds good. It will be available. Yes, option 1 is available with a check button. Now I will just copy paste it and update the variable names. It will be 3. Also here it will be 2. It will be 2 here. It will be 2 here, not it will be 3 here, and 3 as well. Cool. Now all three options are ready with the respective variables, and we can get if user are selected or not in this variable. It will be updated as 1. If user is not selected, it will stay 0, and that's it why we are using it. Now let's create a button. So next, B will be the name, and it will just be a button and root with a text. Next, just simple. Next, B will be packed. Okay, now let's check. Yeah, it's available. Now one more thing I want to do is, I want to add a score label. So let's do that. Score label, I will keep it in the window actually, and for now timing, let's keep other things empty. And I want to place it using a special method, which is place forgot. So what this basically doing is, it will keep this label empty until you update the placing function. So basically now it has forgotten that it has any score label, but if you update it in the program other places, it will show. So that was it from the UI. We are ready with the UI, but one more thing we have to do. When we press one option, multiple options can also be pressed. So now this is a not good method to answer a question. So what we'll do is we'll create a program, a function to not let this happen. So for that I will create a function named check, which will be def, and it will take a parameter option, and for timing let's keep it empty. But what options will it? So if a person selects one option, one, that is checkbox one, which will be option one text, then it will pass a one. So for that I will use command and lambda notation with our function, and it will pass one. So if he selects one, option one, then we'll pass one. If he selects two, option two, we'll pass two. And then if he selects option three, we will pass option three. So yes, that's how we get which option is selected. And now once we get option is selected, so we can just do if option is equal to one, what we can do is we can set the other values as zero. So that's the advantage of using Tkinter variables, which is int var. So now I can set other checkboxes values as zero, then they will automatically be unchecked. So here if option is two, we will update we'll make the first and last as zero, okay. And else, that is here I should use elif. And if the third thing, that is if option is three, then that will be the else part. And in this we just have to set zero to the second one and first one. Yes, now let's check our function, is it working or not. So if I check one, yes, it's good. But when I click second, the first one is gone, and when I click third, the second one is gone. So by this way we have implemented the logic of selecting only one per time. That's great. Now in the next video we will add the functionality of the next button and also displaying the score.